saying a lot of things, but she wouldn't admit to actually why she did this. She just stated her life was over. But again, she would try to throw it back on Adam, but at this point, everything was pointing to her.
Katie's family was right there at the sheriff's office with her. Her parents had driven her there thinking investigators needed her to sign a quick deposition. An hour at most.
And I went to the window and I said, my daughter is
ready. We're going to get bags on my eyes.
Signed the papers.
Oh, wow.
She's supposed to be out half an hour ago. I want to talk to her. And I want her out. I mean, what's going on?
Her parents had no idea she was being interviewed as a suspect. But as the afternoon wore on,
they're not signing a deposition. They're interrogating her for murder. They're interrogating her. So then the door's locked.
Got a lawyer.
To get to my daughter, I beat on the door.
Wow.
And finally, the sheriff came in and I said, my daughter's in there. I says, I want her out now or I want to go in there. Something's wrong here.
It was evening when a detective appeared.
He comes back out. Kathy and I are at the door.
Good.
Katie's not with them.
Good.
And he said, Katie will not be going home
with you tonight.
She is responsible for Mariota's death. We know she did it. She'll be spending the night in jail. My wife passed out.
Good.
She did everything but passed out. I caught her.
Good.
And then he closes the door.
Was this the most helpless you've ever felt in your life?
That you can't help your child, that you are not in control, that you have absolutely no way to put your arms around her and tell her everything's going to be okay.